This conference will now be recorded.
Good morning. Today's topic is list methods. Methods in the list or list methods. Methods in list. Now already started in part one. LEN, max, min, sum. They are completed. Now the one method is the first method is append method. Sir, what is the purpose of the append method? Now the list means is a very important one is a in list insertions are completely allowed. And within the list, inserts are allowed. And within the list, deletions are allowed. Deletions. Deletions are allowed. That means so modification. And one more is a list is mutability. List is mutable. Mutable. List is mutable. So here, the insertions are allowed. Already, list contains, for example, A equal to one list element, 11, 22, then 33, and 44. Any type, not only integer type, always either integer type or something. For example, B equal to one list, B is equal to another list. The list is complete string type Python. Okay, for example, data science. Okay, one is for example AI. It is a one list. Okay, one list. We want to add the new element. That is called as insertions. Insertions means to add new elements to a list. So what are the methods that are used, sir? One method is append method. Append method, insertion purpose. And one method is insert method. One method is insert method. And another method is extend method. These three methods are used to add new elements to the list. Add the new elements, not only deletion, only for addition. Addition purpose, append function, insert function, and extend function. These three functions are used to add new elements to a list. Sir, first point, what is the purpose of the append function? This function is used to add new elements. Add new elements. This function is used to add new elements. Again, sir, at the end of the list. This function is added at the end of the list. For example, it is a list. It's an example one. It is a current list. The list is equal to a value 11, 20, 33, 44. And we have to print the value of a. Before addition, print the value of a. And okay, it's the original value. Now it's also one more value, that is a b. This explained later, no problem. So only purpose function. This function is used to add new elements at the end of the list. End of the list only. Not the middle position. Middle position, we are using the insert function. Extend function is used to more than one element. But here the append function is used to add only one element. Only one element at the end of the list. That's a very important point. Adding only one element, end of the list. So this is the original list. And go to run and run menu, run the module. Now before running, save the file. Very important, the file is without saving, the running is not possible. That is, for example, the list demo or something. Okay, save the demo. And here, this is the value. This is the value of the 11, 22, 33, and 44 is the original list. Please observe this one. Original list. Before addition, the 11, 22, 33, and 44. And after, add the element, a dot append of. For example, a is a list to append of 55. For example, assume that. After addition, add a new element to the end of the list. After addition, add the new element to the end of the list. Okay. The elements are only 11, 20, 33, 44. 55 is added end of the list. Right, now clear. Run this module. Now, this is the original list. This is the original list. 55 is added end of the list. Clear, guys? We are using a dot append of 55 function. Clear. Okay. And the next one is, for example, a dot append of, for example, 66. Clear. A dot append of 77. Okay. A dot append of 88. Add the more number of elements. Number of elements by using the append function. Clear. This function is used to add the new elements at the end of the file. Clear. Very good. For example, it is only for integer list. It is an integer list. For example, if you want to store the list is, for example, another example, second example. It is a, for example, okay, clear? For example, the list is B equal to Python data science AI. For example, we assume that end of B. Now this is the original list. Here B dot append of R, for example, the list is empty list. Or the list is completely empty list. B is equal to empty list. Here the B is equal to empty list. Print of B. That means empty list. After add the new elements one by one. One element is Python, okay. B dot append of one element is example Java, okay. For example, B dot append of one example is completely data science, okay. Okay. Example, B dot append of, for example, is a courses list. The name is equal to courses list. For example, AI, okay. B dot append of, for example, ML, machine learning, okay. B dot append of, for example, DL, deep learning, okay. And print of B, B value is printed. Now here, for example, this is the value. Now here, so first the basic one, the list is empty list. And add a new elements and each and every one, the new elements are added. Run this module. Add a new element each and every at the end of the position. Clear, guys? So now first Python added, Java added, data science added, AI added, ML added, DL is added at the end of the list. This function is used to completely add a new element at the end of the list. Okay, clear. And one more function, is called as an insert function. Second method, the function or method, both are same. The method, second method, insert. This function or this method is used to add a new element, at given index number. At given index number, please observe this point. Here the index number is important, very important. This function is used to add a new element at the given index number. This function add new element at the given index number, specified index number. For example, assume that the index number equal to 11, 22, 33, and 44. This is a original list. I assume that you add a new element. This is a list. In this list, A value, the 11 and 22, 33, and 44. So these are the index numbers are 0, 1, 2, and 3. For example, assume that we add one more element that is equal to 55, for example. Okay. Now here, the number equal to 55. Clear. Okay. For example, add a new element. Add a new element at a given position. I want to add a new element at index number 1. I want to add a new element at a given index number 1. To add the new element index number 1, so 1 is moved to the second, and second element moved to third, and third moved to fourth, and fourth element moved to fifth index number. Now they add the new element. For example, 99 is added at 1. Okay, here the 99 is added, and is a index number 2, 3, 4, and 5. The index number 1 place, they add a new element for the given index number equal to. Clear? Now, print of A, A dot insert of, here the insert function take the two parameters. One parameter is syntax. Syntax of the insert function is insert, of index number, and a new element, The syntax is very important. New element. Now the insert number, okay, index number, and the new element, which element, the index number position, and the new element, two important points, insert of index number and new element. Clear, guys? Now here, insert of, index number 1, add the 99. Print of, please observe this, very important. Now the given position is, the element is added at, this is the original list. This is the original list. 11, 22, 33, 44 is the original list. And here, the inserted element 99 is added at a given position, index number 1. Index number 1 element move to 2, 2, move to 3, and so on. Like this, the new elements are added at a given position. It is completely insert function. Clear? Clear, guys? Up here. The next function is, the third function is extend. So what is extend, sir? This function is, the append function add only one element at the end of the list. The insert function add only one element at a given position. But this function, the extend function, this function is used to add multiple elements, Okay, multiple elements, more than one element to a list. It is very important. Add the multiple elements, not only one element, sir. Add the multiple elements to a list. Okay, clear. Add the multiple elements, very important. Right, the next one, for example, how to add, sir, A equal to one list, 11, 22, 33, and 44. For example, the B equal to another list, for example, 100, 200, 300, 400, 500. It's another list, A dot extend of B, add B means multiple elements. B means not a single element, multiple elements, 100, 200, 300, 400. It is a list. This list is extended to A. This list already A is 11, 20, 30, 44. The entire list is added to A. Now after, okay, here, before, after adding print of A. Now what is A, sir? Now after adding the, what is A? Value of A is, okay, 11, 20, 30, 44. New elements are added to a given list A. More than one elements are added. More than one elements are, action function, it takes only one argument. That's a new elements are added. This is example one. Example one. For example, sir, another example. If you want to add the more than one elements are, is also okay, nice. For example, x equal to one list. It is a one list. The list is empty list. X dot extent of more than one element are added, range of 1 comma 11 comma 1. Now the print of x. Clear? X is a ordinary list. In this list element, we are adding the element one by one. Here there is an empty list. This empty list, you add the only one element are added. One by one elements are added. This, but here the list elements are x dot extend of range of 1 comma 11. So 1 to 10 elements are added to x only one statement. By using only one statement, more than one elements are added to given list by using the extend function. Clear? Okay, clear. These three functions are mainly used in the insertion purpose. One is append function, and one is a insert function, and one is a extend function. These three functions are mainly used in the insertion purpose. And the deletion purpose. Okay, in the Python, deletions are also allowed. What are the functions are used in the deletion purpose? Three functions are used. One function is pop function, one function is remove function, one function is clear function. These three functions are used to removing purpose, deletion purpose. Now, what is the first function? The first function is pop function. Sir, what is the pop? This function is used to pop. This function is used to, okay, remove the last element from a list. This function is used to remove the last element from a list. Here the last element. For example, last element is, we are declaring one list A equal to, this is the list, okay, the list, and the print of A before deleting A dot pop means the last element is removed. Here, remove the last element, pop function. This function is used to remove the last element. Here the last element is, which is the last element? The last element is 44. The last element is removed from the list. After removing, the list elements are only 11, 22, and 33 only, right? Clear? That is the, after the last element is removed. Last element removed. For example, if you want to remove the one more last element, is it possible? If you want to remove the another last element, that's also possible. Now here, last elements are 11, 30, 44. Okay, first 44 removed last element, next 33 removed, next 22 removed, only one. For example, if you are using A dot pop, all the elements are removed from the list. Automatically, the list is empty list. Okay, the list is empty list. Clear, guys? This element is called as a pop, right? And the next one is, sir, what is remove function, sir? What is the purpose of the remove? Another function. Fifth one, remove. Now this function is used to remove the specified element. Or particular element, specified element from a list. Specified element from the list. For example, your list 11, 22, okay, elements 33 and 44, and 55. Remove the specified element from the list. Each element with the previous example, pop means remove the last element. Here, print of A, print the value. A dot remove the specified element. That is, the specified element is 22 is removed from the list. The specified element is 22. Example, A dot remove of 33 is removed from the list. After removing 22 and 33, print the value of A. Print of A on this module. And the version values 11, 20, 33, 44. And removing the numbers are 22. Removing the numbers are 33. Both these three elements removed from the, these three elements removed from the list. Clear, guys? For example, here one thing is important. One point is important, very important. For example, remove of 99. The 99 is not present. For example, remove of, for example, Python. The python, here the python is not present. The python is not present. Then what happens, sir? When what happened? The present elements are only 11, 22, 33, 44, 55 only. For example, A dot remove of, for example, data science. The data science is not present. The data science element is not present in the list. Then what happens? Please observe this one. Okay. 22 remote, 33 remote, and then what happens? Here that it has the value error list remove of x, that means x is not present. X is not in a list. What is x means? That is the data science not in a list. This function automatically returns the error. Then what happens? For example, if the given element not present in a list, then it returns which error? Returns the value error, V capital, and E also capital, remove the built-in error. Clear, guys? This remove function, if the element is present, remove it. 22 is present, remove the element. 33 is present, remove the element. But then 88 data science is not present, then automatically discover the error. This is called as a exception handling in Python. I will explain that later. No problem, it's a separate chapter. Now here is the element. Clear. And the next sixth function is, what is the sixth function? This function, clear function. This means remove. This function is used to remove all elements. Not only one element, all elements from a list. This function is used to remove all elements from a list. Remove all elements from your list. How it is possible, sir? Directly by using the clear function. Not only one element, not only last element, not the last element, not only one element. Remove all elements. So 11, 22, 33, 44, 55 is a given list. Print the value of A. So A dot clear. Print of A. That's nice. Okay. Without clear function, that is not possible to remove. But by using the programming, one element is removed. So now A dot clear, removing the all element. After removing, the list is empty list. Clear. Automatically list is empty list. This is the clear function. The removing three functions. One is a pop, one is a remove, another one is a clear. The next function, the seventh function is sort function. And here the sort is very important, sorting. This function, seventh one is sort method. And what is the use of this function? This function is used to sort the elements. In which purpose are sorting? Sort the elements in either another two ways. One is ascending order sorting, or another one is a descending order. What is ascending order, sir? Ascending order means, okay, sort the elements lowest value to highest value. And descending order means to sort the elements highest value to lowest value. For example, these are the elements. For example, assume that these are the elements. Elements are 8, 1, 3, 90. Okay, for example, 34. These are the elements. How to sort the elements in different ways? One is the ascending order. For what is the ascending order, sir? The ascending order is the first one, and then next 4, next 8, and next 34, next 90. These are the elements. This is ascending order. And the descending order means 90, and next one 34, next 8, next 4, next 1. This means highest value to lowest value. Highest value 90, 34, 8, 4, and 1. Lowest to highest. It is called as a ascending order. Ascending order. There are the two types of sorting, ascending order and descending order. Very important, two types of sorting. Right, clear. For example, here I assume that K equal to Rx equal to Rm equal to Ry equal to Rn equal to any one value. K equal to, for example, 11, 2, 88, 9, for example, 34. It is a one list. 34, 5 is a one list. So the total number of elements are 6 elements. Start the elements in ascending order. Print of A value. Okay. Print of A dot sort simply. A dot sort. Print the value of the A value. 1 minute, check it first and then export this one. Here the none value. Sir, what is the none remaining here? For example, first to sort, and then print the way. First to sort the values and then print of A. And here values are, for example, here these are the values. 11, 2, 88, 9, 34. After sorting, the result is assigned to A only, is 11. After sorting, the way values are changed to 5, 9, 11, 34, and 88. This is the sorting process. The sorting is only for ascending order. First to sort the values, and then after sorting, print the value. This is A, and this is also A. A values are changing, right, complete. Run this module. Now, the values are 2, 5, 9, 11, 34, and 88. This type of sorting is called a ascending order. Clear, guys, are clear or not? For example, similarly, if you want to print the order in ascending order, not ascending order, descending order. For example, to print the elements in descending order. Okay, we want to print the elements in descending order. A equal to, assume that 11, 2, 88, 9, 34 and 5. Right, 34 and 5. Okay. Before descending, print the value. And A dot sort of, okay, values. A dot sort, and after sorting, print. This type of sorting is called as a ascending order. If you want to print the descending order, we can use the one element that is equal to reverse equal to true. After sorting, the entire elements are placed in the reverse order, and the value is assigned to A. Clear, check it. The output is 8, 88, 34, 11, 9, 5, and 24. This is the descending order. When you are using the descending order, if you want to print the elements in descending order, now we can use the reverse equal to true format. It's in the parenthesis, it is an argument. Check it. Reverse equal to by default order is ascending order only. By default, note this very important for this point. To sort the elements in ascending order. Okay, clear, guys. By default, to sort the elements in ascending order. Clear. And the next one more important function, that is the reverse function. So seventh one is sort, and here the eighth function is the reverse. This function is used to arrange the element in reverse order, simply in the reverse order. For example, A equal to, it is a list, 11, 22, 33, and 44, and 55. These elements can be arranged in the reverse order. Print of A dot reverse. Okay. A dot reverse. And here, the elements are print of A. Clear. Elements are result in descending. Well, not sorting, only for is weight. So arrange the elements in reverse order. Right? This is the reverse order. This is the result. Original order is 11, 20, 33, 44. The reversing order is 55, 44, 32, 33, 22, and 11. It is called as a reversing order. Clear, guys, up to here. And the next one, the next function, the ninth function, also very important function, that is copy function. Copy. This function is used to copy the elements from one list to another list. This function is used to copy the elements from one list to another list. The same elements copied to one list to another list. Example, it is a list. A is a one list. The same elements are copied to another variable only. It's the copy. This function is used to copy the elements from one list to another list. A values, for example, okay, B equal to A dot copy. That means all the B A values, all the A values are copied to B. All the A values are copied to B. After copying, A and B both are having the same values. Both are having the same value. And print of A, 11, 20, 30, 44, 55. And print of B, B also 11, 22, 33, 44, and 55. All the elements are containing, all the variables are containing the same value. For example, we are using C equal to A dot copy. Value of A is copied to B, C. And we have print of C. All the A, B, C are same values. A dot copy. This is A, this is B, and this is B. This is called as a copy function. The copy function is used to copy the values from one element to another element. Clear, guys? Up to here. Next, after completing the methods, the next one is mathematical operations on list. Mathematical operations. Operations on list. Sir, what is the method? What are the mathematical operations? There are the three types of mathematical operations. Mathematical operations means plus, minus, multiplication, division, percentile, slash, slash, okay, double star. These are the mathematical. These are the arithmetic operations or mathematical operations. And less than, greater than, less than equal, greater than equal, okay, and greater than equal, and not equal, and equal to. These are the mathematical operations. But here in the list, we are using only plus operation. We are using only plus operation, and we are using only multiplication operation. Not slash. All these operators are not used. And the list we are using equal to operand, double equal to. The first one is called as a addition operation. It is called as commonly it is known as a addition operation. Here we are using a list concatenation operator. Here the addition is called as a list concatenation operator. This is called as a list concatenation. Second one is a star is called list repetition. Repetition operator. Second one is list repetition operator. List repetition operator. That is the star value. This is the star value. That's all. That is the list repetition operator. The operator is called as a star operator. And one more operator. And the third one, list comparison. List comparison operator. Comparison operator is equal to operator. Okay, equal to list comparison. So the first one is list concatenation operator. Okay, so that is a plus. Sir, what is the purpose of the list concatenation? This operator is used to concatenate concatenation of two or more. It's only additions, concatenation, joining of two or more lists. One list equal to so and so value. Okay, this is one list. B equal to another list. Values are okay. And C equal to another list. This is the list. Python. Okay. Right, AI, and the other list. B equal to A plus B plus C. That means concatenate of A, B values into C. This is the original list. Clear? What is the purpose of the mathematical operations in list? Mathematical operation in list is concatenation operator. Yes, this operator concatenate two or more lists. Here using more list, A plus B plus C. These three lists are concatenated. The result is assigned to D. Print of B. After concatenation, D value equal to A plus B values plus C value. All the values are assigned to D. Right? Observe this one. Run this module. Now, the D value. This is the D value. The D. This is the entire list. D means A value plus B values plus C values. For example, we are using the X also. X equal to sum. Any value. So the X value equal to, for example, C. C plus plus. Java and so on. This is X. Here we are using the X also. Add the element plus X. Now run this module. All the elements are added to A, D. all the elements are added to the, it is called as a concatenation. Clear guys, the operator is called as a concatenation. Now one more operator, and the second operator, list replication. List replication, that is a star, star. This function is used to repeat a list n number of times, n, n means any number, n number of times. That means repeat a list in 5 times or 2 times or 1 time or any number of times. For example, here, this is a list, C equal to, this is a list. Simple example, C equal to one list and C equal to one list, C equal to, sorry. Or B equal to one list, B equal to one list. Here, the list B equal to one list. And before multiplication, only print the value of the B only. After multiplication, print off, okay, B star 4. Print the values in B values in 4 times. What is the meaning of this statement? This statement prints only 1 time. This statement prints 4 times. And run this module. This is called as a string list repetition, 4 times. First time, second time, third time, and fourth time. If you want to print the repeat in the list in, okay, one more time, print off B star, okay, B dot 50 times. Print the values of B in 50 times, n number of times. That means n here, n value 50 times. The same list is repeated 50 times, 50 times. Here n, this function is used to repeat a list n number of times. That means n means 4 times, n means 50 times, n means any number of times. Now here, for example, okay, these two are the list operations. First one is the concatenation, second one is the repetition, and the third one is the list comparison operation. List comparison operations. So what is the list comparison operator, sir? That means it is equal to double equal to. Double equal to. Double equal to means list comparison. Comparison. Both lists are true, both are same or not. This operator is used to compare two or more lists. It returns only two values, either true value or false value. Either true value or false value. It returns only two values, either true or false. This function is only either true value or false value. When both the lists are having the same values, it returns true. Otherwise, it is the value equal to false. For example, both the lists are same values, returns true. Otherwise, it returns false. For example, one equal to A equal to, okay, it is easy. B equal to, for example, one list, 100, 200, okay, one list. C equal to, for example, 11, 22, 33, 44, okay, another list. D equal to, for example, 24, 33, 22, 11. Okay, assume that A value, B value, and C value. Now both these two are equal or not. Print off A equal to B, true or false. A double equal to means comparison. What is the meaning of A equal to B? A equal to B means value of B is assigned to A. Here this statement single equal to means the value of B is assigned to A. But double equal to means compare the A and B values. Compare the A and B values. Compare the A and B values. Here the comparison only, A and B comparison, A and B both are, but not the same values, that is a false value. Print of A equal to C, A and B are the same values. Print of A equal to D, A and B are the same value or different value? Different values, but not the same value. Here A of 0 value, 11, B of 0 value is 40, but that's a different value, it returns the value equal to false. Run this module. Returns the answer. The answer is first one false, second one true, third one false. First one false, second one true, third one is false. This is called as a list comparison. Okay, now the list comparison operations. Clear guys, list comparison. Clear, there are the three values. One is the list concatenation, one is a list repetition, another one is a list comparison operations. Clear. And the next one, another one, and okay, membership operators, okay, in lists. Sir, what are the membership operators that are available, sir? The membership operators are two. The membership operators are, you know already, membership operators are two. membership operators are two. One is a in operator, another one is a not in operator. What is in operator? In operator means penalty. What is in operator? It returns true. Value present in your list, it returns true. A value, the given value, the given value, the given value present in a list, the given value present in list, returns true. Otherwise, returns false. Otherwise, returns false. It is called as a in operator. In operator. If the given value present in a list returns true, otherwise false. But not in operator. Not in operator. If the given value, this is opposite of the completely. Opposite value. In and not in. These two are the opposites. If the given value not present, not present in a list, then it returns true. Otherwise, returns false. This is called as in and not in operators. In list, clear. Next one, for example, assume that A equal to 11, 22, 33, and 44. Okay, print off, for example, 9 in A, true or false. Print off 9 in present or not, 9 not present in A, address the value equal to false. For example, print off 11 in A. 11 present in A is a value. For example, print of 55 not in A, what is the output? For example, print of 43 not in A. Clear? These are the elements 9, 11, 55, and 33. These are the elements. Now, that is the value. First one is 99. First one is 9 value. The first value is 9. 9 in present A, okay, false. 11 in A, true. 55 not in A, true. 33 not in A, false. By using the in and not in operators in list, clear. And one more value using for loop in list. How to repeat the for loop? For loop in list. This is called, sometimes it is called as a iteration in list. Iteration in list. For example, it is a list. Assume that print the value 11, 22, 33, and 44. Print the value. These are the values, printing these values. Okay. Printing these values, for example, print of for loop, for i in A, and print of i. Here, explain the loop one by one. For example, here, first statement, A is a list. Okay. The element, this is a A list, 11, 22, and 33. And 44. The elements are stored the index number 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, clear guys. The 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay. Next one. For i in a means what is the value of i a? 11, 22, 33, and 44. Clear. Okay. Here, what is the output? For loop is repeatedly executed. For i in first time, the I value equal to 11. First time I value is 11. Here, what is the value of I? And what is the output? Here, very first time, the I value is 11. Okay, clear. The I value is 11. It takes the I value is 11. The control entered into the loop. The enter into the loop, print of I. Print the value of I. Okay. Again, the go to back. Next time, the I value equal to 22. I value equal to 22. Okay. And control entered into the loop, print of I. The I value equal to 22. Again, go to back. Next time, I value equal to 33. I value equal to 33. Print the value of 33. Again, go to back. I value equal to 44. Print the value of 44. And next one, I go to back and I value no more items in the list. The values are not present in your list. The values are not present in your list. That's why to stop the loop. It is a iteration in loops. Iteration in lists. For example, another example. Okay, print it. Execute this one. For example, we want to using the same concept in lists also in for loop. Okay, for example, another example for i in a, rx, any value x. Okay, now here this is the x equal to, for example, assume that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Here to print the cubes of x. Print of i into i. Okay. Print the i value and cube value. or on this one. This is the iteration. I value, Q value, 2 value, Q value, 3 value, Q value, I value, Q value, and both the value. For example, in between both these two, okay, and the value of output also same. Original value, Q value. Okay, one and so on, repeat on this process. It is a iteration in list, the concept is. Okay.